Hi guys, hope you guys are having a wonderful day or night wherever you are in the world. Paul here. On this video, I'd just like to talk about certain questions that I've been receiving for quite some time now. It's about my old band, the band that recorded Mahal Pa Rin Kita and Parting Time. You know the name of the band that I'm talking about, right? There's been many questions like, why did you leave? Why did you leave the country? Why did you leave the band? Questions like that. What happened? Were you guys not getting along? Or are you coming back to Philippines? Are you gonna go back to the Philippine music industry? Questions like these. Well, it's a pretty long story. Okay? I'm gonna answer them one by one. Okay, the first question, what happened to the band? I'm gonna name the band the Parting Time Band, okay? I'm not gonna name the name because you guys already know that I do not like the name. That's why we changed the name to Arcasia. Okay, because as far as the Western people are concerned, you know, that name is not a band name, you know. It's, how do I explain this? It's like, have you heard of a band called The Very Good Band? Have you heard of a band called The Great Band? No, right? Have you heard of a band called The Amazing? No, right? Have you heard of a band called The Wealthy? No, right? Have you heard of a band called The One and Only? Those are not names. Those are adjectives. Those are the things you say before or after a name. You understand? So I did not like the name, but because I wanted to get into the music industry so bad, because I come from a poor family. We are not very well off, you know, as some people might think, you know. I mean, our family is okay now, but back then when I was young, not so. My father was a chef at the Subic Naval Base. Yes, he also was a bus driver. And he's a very industrious man. He managed to get us a house, you know. So, you know, I grew up living in our own house. We were not renting. But we are not rich. There are many musicians that come from well-off family. When I was growing up, we were having financial struggles. Me, Alan, and Hazel, we do not come from well-off family. You know, Norman and Rodel were doing better. Their families were a little bit better off compared to ours, compared to me and Alan and Hazel. Now, when I wanted to get into the industry, when I wanted to get signed up, I went to Manila and presented my demos to various record labels, right? But I did not get anybody's attention. So during those days, it was a cassette tape, right? So I went there and presented my demo to Viva, OctoArts, ABS-CBN, to Warner, MCA Universal. I presented my demo tape to these, you know, Vicor Records. So I couldn't get in. My first recording experience in a recording studio was with a band based in Alangapo City that was Norman Kimson's band before. The band was called Jukebox and they were signed up with ABS-CBN. And their first album made a gold record award, and their second album I was included. So Norman and Jong Azores got me in. They were basically the, you know, the controllers of the band, because Norman and Jong were the songwriters of the band, the Jukebox. And I got to join the band, and that was my first experience in a recording studio in Manila. Yeah, it was great. And then time went on, I wanted to do my own thing, you know. I kept presenting demos and all that, but I wasn't getting any attention. there was a time that I, in 1990, I went to Japan as an overseas contract worker as a musician. We were playing in bars and pubs there in Japan. And then there I met Rosano de Jesus. He's our bass player in Japan. Me and him did not really play together, but we worked for the same company. We had 4 or 5 bands playing for that same company, and we're all friends, of course. So one of our bass players, within the 5 bands, one of the bass players was Rosano de Jesus. We call him Ross. So Ross and I became friends, of course. As time went on, Ross heard my demo. Ross started his own bar in Angeles, in the fields. You call it the fields. And then this place was full of bars. Hooker bars, karaoke bars, you name it. There are some bars with live music there too. And Ross opened up a bar there, and his bar was very successful. And then he had this customer who always went to his bar. He and Ross became friends because they're both musicians, of course. So Ross called me up and said, "Hey Paul, I know this guy. He's one of my regular customers in my bar. His name is Benny Saturno." And I'm like, "Okay, so what's up?" Well, I gave him your demo tape, and I think he's interested. "Well, why, what is he?" "Well, he's very connected in the business. He has produced many records. He's basically a producer. He can represent you to get in the music industry." And I'm like, "Wow, interesting." So Ross set up a meeting. "Okay, Paul, why don't you come over to my bar and then have a drink with me and Venny, and then we can chat a little bit and see what happens." So that's what we did. I came over from Olongapo. I went to Angeles, and that's how we met. I met Venny right there. We had a little bit of a drink. He said he liked the song Cinta a lot. Cinta, right? I'm like, "Okay, cool." But then again, as time went on, so he did hook us up. He says, "Let's call the band Rockstar." And I'm like, "I don't like the name, but you know what? Because I really wanted to get in the industry. Okay, fine. I'll take it. Maybe after one album we'll just change it." That was what was in my heart and the band members' hearts. We were all thinking the same thing. You know, Rodel, Alan, Norman. You know. So we changed the name to Arcasia after the first album. Simple as that. And why did I leave the band? That's the second question. Actually, I did not leave the band. I just went solo because I have so many ideas and things I wanted to do. But you know, I didn't really get to do most of the things I wanted to do because, you know, I got controlled by the producers. You know, it's like, "Ah, Paul, it's gotta be this, gotta be this." So I, you know, so we did the Wishing Heart album. And then later on, my deal with Viva was over. So, you know, I got signed with MCA Universal. Same thing. They wanted this, they wanted that. They wanted to turn me into a matinee idol, like a handsome, cute boy. I didn't want that. I wanted to be a band. I wanted to be like Bryan Adams, you know. Bryan Adams is a band. Huey Lewis is a band, you know. Huey Lewis in the News. I wanted to be Sapiera as a band, you know. Although I am the leader, yeah, of course, it's me. It's my band. But I wanted to be a band, you know. Yeah, it's what I wanted. And then